Show. We are filming our show today on Monday, July the 17th. My name is Jeanette Higgins and I'm a volunteer with the Noonan Coweta Humane Society. And what our group does is we come down here to Coweta County Animal Control and we showcase as many of the fur babies and fur kids, as we like to call them, that we can get on the show in this segment in hopes that somebody out there will see one of these precious little furry faces, you'll fall in love and you'll want to rush on down here and adopt a pet. So guys, please do stay tuned and we hope that you enjoy the show. And folks, we're starting off the show today with an absolute love. This is Beethoven and he is obviously, as you can see, a black and white kitty. We like to call these the cow kitties because they kind of look like a dairy cow. But Beethoven here is, they're showing him only about 10 months, so he may still have a little spunky kitten side to him, but he is just so sweet. He's hanging out in C15. He was picked up as a stray from Tranquil Road, and I tell you what, he is headbutting and purring and loving and kissing and just, he's doing these little love nibbles, so don't think that he's trying to bite you. Sometimes the male cats, especially when they get overstimulated and they just get so happy and they're so loving, they'll give you this little love nibble, and it doesn't hurt, and it's just their way of just saying, I just can't hardly contain myself, I love you so much, I gotta take me a little bite. Yeah. So it doesn't hurt, yeah, but he's just precious, folks. Oh my goodness. He's purring like mad. He is just loving our volunteer, Suzanne, for sure, and he would love to love on you. So if you want a highly affectionate cat, then definitely come on down and adopt Beethoven. He's down here at Animal Control just waiting for you. And folks, we have a real sweetheart here that is just so scared. This is Bella. She is a Lab Retriever mix. Only about 4.5 months old, this precious little girl is just absolutely terrified. Sweet as pie, but just so, so scared. Bella is hanging out in B13. She was picked up as a stray from Skylark Circle. No collar, no ID. And as you can see, she's a really pretty brown and white coloring, kind of some patches, you know, all over her. And just a really neat size. I mean, even though she's a Lab Retriever mix, she's on the smaller size. I mean, they're showing that she's a puppy, but I don't believe she's gonna get much bigger. She's probably gonna be more of a small to medium sized dog, but just perfect as far as we're concerned. And I love these ears that are just straight as little arrows coming off of her head. She wants to make sure she doesn't miss hearing anything around her because like I said, she is very, very scared, but also super sweet. And just really needs to be in a home with somebody that can make her feel safe and loved. And I promise you, she's going to give you tons of love back. So come on down and adopt Bella. She's down here at Animal Control just waiting to be your new best friend. Oh my goodness, folks. I tell you what, this is a really, really sweet cat. And as you can see, she just is loving every minute of it. She keeps headbutting my hand. She doesn't want to sit still because she is just so affectionate. She just wants to show love and give love and just purr the day away. So Nadine here, as you can see, is a gorgeous example of a tortie. She's got the swirled kind of markings and stuff all over her, what we call marbled. And she is actually a Manx. It's the bobtail where they don't have a tail. I don't know if she was born that way or if maybe she got injured and they had to remove the tail, but either way, she looks like a little rabbit with this little tiny little stub on the back here that we call a tail. But Nadine here is about 2 years old, and this precious girl was picked up as a stray from Hines Road, no collar, no ID. She's hanging out in C1. And look at her. She is just loving this. I tell you what, if you, you know, come home from work after a long day and you've had a bad day, just come home to Nadine. Let her sit in your lap and just purr the rest of the day away. And I tell you what, she'll put a big smile on your face. And, you know, people always tell me all the time how their dogs come to the door and greet them when they come home. Well, cats will do that too. My cat does that. He comes running to the door with the dogs. He thinks he's a dog and greets me when I come home each day. So it's just a wonderful thing, folks. If you don't have a pet in your life, you got to have one because it really adds so much to your home. And they just love unconditionally. You know, they just want to be loved and they want to give love. And they're just so sweet. And as you can see, Nadine just can't get enough, can't give enough. So come on down and rescue Nadine. And guys, we have a very scared little girl here, this Chihuahua, and she's probably purebred. I mean, she's just absolutely precious. Her name is Loretta, or rather her nickname here at Animal Control is Loretta. This girl was picked up from Highway 16 in the Robinson Road area in a traffic accident. So we don't know if her owner passed away or you know, what happened in that situation, but she didn't do anything wrong. She was just hanging out in the car with her owner and all this happened, and now she's here at Animal Control. So of course she's very disoriented and very scared, and who can blame her? I mean, my goodness, she's a tiny little thing. And you know, it's loud back there in the kennel, and there are big dogs and small dogs and medium dogs, all size dogs all around her. And she just doesn't understand what's going on, but we do know that she needs to get a new home. So Loretta here is in B9. That is her kennel number. We don't know her age. We know she's fully grown. She's already been spayed, so you can get a discount on the adoption fee here at Animal Control. So we just don't want to see this precious little girl spend very much time here because she's just so afraid and is, you know, she's potty trained, house trained. She held her business until Anne took her out of the cage and outside. So we know that, like I said, she's already house trained. And she just needs somebody to just give her lots of love because right now she's scared and doesn't know where mom and dad went. So come on down and rescue sweet little Loretta. She's down here at Animal Control just waiting for you. And folks, we have an absolute little sweetie cutie pie here. This is Jamie. And Jamie is an orange tabby, but what we like to call the buff tabby because Jamie has little muted colors. And I don't know, is Jamie a boy or a girl? Do we know? It doesn't say on the card. I think we named this kitty Jamie because it could go either way. So we'll have to wait till Jamie's a little bit older before we decide if this is a boy or a girl. But I would have to say probably a boy only because generally the orange tabbies are male. But because it's the buff coloring and also has some white, that's kind of throwing me off a little bit. So we'll have to wait and see when Jamie gets a little older. But either way, I can promise you whether this kitty is a boy or a girl, this kitty is full of sugar, as sweet as sugar. Look at that little paw. Orange tabby, but you can also see the little white streak going down the middle and little white paws and just absolutely darling. So Jamie's hanging out in C9. And I'm gonna say she, just because I think it's a girl, but who knows. It's picked up as a stray from Walnut Drive, now wants to play with Suzanne's hand, but only about 2 months old, going on 3 months, and just absolutely stinking adorable. So I tell you what, you know, if you want a little sweetie pie to grow up in your home and just fill it with lots of love and sunshine, then you definitely wanna have Jamie there. So come on down and rescue Jamie. And guys, we have just a really special girl here to present to you this morning. This is little Miss Isabel. I say little, but she's not so little, but she is just wonderful, guys. I mean, as soon as I came in the room, she just was grinning from ear to ear. She's got the biggest smile on her face, just as goofy and silly and loving as you can possibly imagine. Isabel is a terrier mix. This girl is hanging out in B2. And she was picked up from Ishman Ballard. They scanned her, no ID. And I tell you what, folks, she is absolutely gorgeous. She's got this wonderful white coat. I don't know her age, it's not on her card, but we know she's not a puppy, she's fully grown. She's probably had some puppies at some point, but she is here at Animal Control now, just needing somebody to give her a new home. You know, open up your heart, open up your home, and give this girl a forever home. So if you're interested in Isabel, please hurry on down and get this girl. I tell you what, she will warm your heart, your home, and everything else with that great smile. So come on down and rescue this precious girl. And folks, we all love good cats, so now you can get Mr. Good Cat. That is this guy's nickname. He's still scared though, even though he's a big old boy, he's still very scared because he did nothing wrong, just got lost, ended up as a stray here at Animal Control. But he is hanging out in C18. He is right at a year old, so happy birthday, Mr. Good Cat. He was picked up as a stray off of Holbrook Road. Of course, you know, they scanned him, no microchip. And you know, folks, when you microchip your dog, you can also microchip your cat. And it's a really good idea, even if they're a cat that doesn't ever go outside. You never know if, you know, if you have a fire and your pets get out. You need to always make sure that even though you have a collar around their neck that has ID tags or anything like that, that can be taken off or it can fall off. So even if you have an indoor-only cat or indoor-only pet, please, please go ahead and get the microchip, because like I said, something could happen in your home where everybody is running out every door and your cat will do the same thing. So make sure you microchip those cats. But anyway, if you're looking for a very handsome brown tabby, then definitely you want to come down and meet Mr. Good Cat. So come on down and rescue this handsome fella. And folks, here we have a very sweet puppy girl. This is Maggie, and Maggie is a black and tan hound mix, as you can see. She is only about 6 or 7 months old, and this pretty girl is hanging out in B17. Now, she is heartworm negative. She's had her shot, she's been dewormed, and she's ready to give you tons of puppy kisses. Little Maggie here was picked up as a stray from Little Road, no ID. And oh my goodness, she's just so sweet, folks. I mean, she just wants to be petted. She was laying on her back and having her volunteer rub her belly, and she is just so precious. I mean, she loves people, she loves getting all this attention for sure, and she just wants to love on you and give you puppy kisses and get a belly rub from you as well. So if you're interested in Maggie, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this precious puppy girl. And folks, we're having lots of fun with this little sweetheart. This is Pixar, and this little guy is an orange tabby with some white. Of course, I love the orange male tabbies. They are just so sweet and so much fun. And Pixar is definitely that sweet, loving, fun, playful kitten that everybody would just love to have. He's kind of a medium haired. He's not gonna be short haired. He's not certainly not gonna be long haired, but he's got a little fluff to his fur and is just curious and sweet as can be. He is hanging out in C27. That's his cat condo number. He was picked up as a stray from Old Corinth Road. No collar, no ID, but oh my goodness, we just love this little guy. He is just so, so sweet. I don't know his exact age, but I think looking at his size, I'd probably say 2 to 3 months. He's not old. He's certainly all kitten and all boy, but also all cute. So if you're interested in little Pixar, please hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this little sweetheart. And folks, some of our loyal viewers may recognize this boy. He has been on the show before. This is Wesley. And Wesley is a tan and white Lab Retriever Alaskan Husky mix. Wow, that is a lot to say, Wesley. This handsome fella is hanging out in B19. That's his kennel number. He was picked up as a stray from Westgate Park Lane. He's had his shots. He's been dewormed. And he has been here so long, folks. I mean, my goodness, he's turning a year old because he's been sitting here at Animal Control for so many months. He has actually been here since March. And so we just want to make sure that this precious boy gets a home and doesn't end up losing his life here at Animal Control. Right now, to my knowledge, there's not any euthanasia list, but because he has been here so long, he is definitely at a higher danger of possibly ending up on some sort of a list. And there's nothing wrong with him, guys. He came in all puppy, and he still acts like all puppy. He needs a little bit of training because he's not used to walking on a leash, but you know what? He's smart as a whip, and he's highly trainable, and he would definitely make a wonderful, loyal companion to anyone who is lucky enough to add him to their family. So if you're interested in Wesley, please hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this sweet boy and give him a forever home. And folks, this little guy is Carson, and Carson is jet black. He's still a kitten, very playful, very sweet. He's got this kind of cottony feel to his fur. You can tell that he's still a baby, but just absolutely adorable. And I love the the dark black jet fur with those gold kind of colored eyes set back in there. he just thinks that we're all just kittens and we're all just all here for him to play with. But such a cute, cute boy. Now Carson is hanging out in C7. That's his cat condo number. He was picked up as a stray from Walnut Drive. Looks like he's probably about 2 to 3 months old, something like that. But just a rambunctious little dude, just really wants to play and have fun and be your buddy. And certainly you guys would be best friends for sure, because he's not just a lap cat. He's also very playful and fun. And I know there's this silly superstition about black cats, but you know what? I have never met a black cat I didn't love, because it doesn't matter what they look like on the outside. It's all about the inside. And actually, most of the black cats I've ever met have been really, really sweet. I mean, I would compare them to the sweetness of the orange male tabbies that I always talked about. They're just super sweet. So if you're looking for a jet black, handsome little fella, then come on down and adopt Carson and give this little sweetie pie a forever home. And I tell you what, he's going to be forever in your heart. Hey, folks, we are having lots of fun with this boy for sure. This is Earl. He is a beagle mix, brown and white, as you can see. He's probably not going to sit still now because all these people are coming in and out of the room. He's getting really, really excited. He wants to go play with everybody. But he's got these little freckles on his snout. And it's just a wonderful boy. I tell you what, it just makes you smile as soon as you see him. He is about 4 years old. He was picked up as a stray from Foxhall Crossing West. No collar, no ID. He has had his shots. He's been dewormed. He's already been neutered, so you can get a discount on his adoption fee because of that. I do have to mention that they did test him for heartworms. He tested positive. And with the money that you saved by not having to pay for him to be neutered, then you can use that to pay for heartworm treatment, get him on a heartworm preventative, and then he is good to go. And you don't have to worry about that anymore. So if you are interested in Earl, please hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this handsome fella. I tell you what, that tail is just a-going, a-going, a-going. It's like a whip.
He found bacon.
Yeah. Oh, yummy. He found some treats. Oh, boy. So he is super, super sweet, folks, and he is sure to put a smile on your face for the rest of his life. So come on down and rescue Earl. And folks, you are seeing something very rare here at Animal Control. We are actually holding some Siamese twins. These little boys are so teeny tiny, and like I said, we very rarely ever see Siamese cats or kittens come through Animal Control. I am holding little Logan. And our volunteer, Suzanne, has Paul, the brother. I'm going to hold Logan a little closer to me because he's actually trembling. So come up here, sweetheart. These little babies are only about 4 weeks old. I mean, barely even 4 weeks. They're probably more like 3 weeks old. Teeny tiny little things, have not been held very much, but just need somebody to, you know, to give them some extra TLC, make them feel safe, and let them know that, you know, humans are not going to hurt them. We want to love on them, and they'll be fine. They just are so scared right now, but gorgeous. Of course, they're going to keep those beautiful blue eyes and just stay as handsome and gorgeous as they are right now. They're both hanging out in C2. They were picked up as strays from Country Club Road. And, you know, we would really love to see them go together and be adopted together because they are so frightened. But certainly if you can only take one, we understand. But like I said, these little babies, for them to really thrive and be happy and be safe and secure, they need a little buddy. So if you can possibly take both Logan and Paul, that would be wonderful. But either way, we want to make sure that both these little cutie pies get a forever home. And I know that there's somebody out there that is looking at these guys right now thinking, wow, I can't believe they have Siamese kittens down there in Animal Control. And this is it. So you better hurry if you're interested in these boys. But come on down and rescue little Logan and little Paul and give these guys a forever home. And guys, some of our loyal viewers may recognize this girl as well. This is Quinn, and she has been on our show multiple times. She is a white and brown boxer mix, about 2 years old, and Quinn is hanging out in A20. That's her kennel number. She was picked up as a stray from the Tommy Lee Cook Gym Star area. She was wearing a pink collar, which she still has on now, but it's not really pink so much as it's kind of a faded purple. But either way, if somebody recognizes her, we still are hopeful that you know, her family will find her. And because she has been here since March, though, there's probably not as much of a chance that she'll be able to be reunited with her family. So at this point, we really just want to make sure she gets a forever home and doesn't end up on one of the euthanasia lists anytime. So just a wonderful dog, guys. She's so sweet. She's so good out in the yard area. She's really smart, just very loving. You know, she's a boxer, so if you know the boxer breed, they tend to like to jump on you and do this little kind of boxing thing, and that's just what they do. But you can train her not to jump. I mean, it's a very easy thing to do. And as you can see, she loves people, loves all this attention. It's just a happy-go-lucky girl wagging that tail. So if you're interested in Quinn, please hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this sweet girl. She's gonna love on you and be your best friend and get lots of scratches and just be a happy, happy girl. And she will make your home and your life just so much more happy as well. So come on down and rescue Quinn. And that is our show for today, folks. Thank you so very much for tuning in. And guys, I just want to mention that when you're thinking about donating to Animal Control, I know they need dog food and cat food, but right now they really, really need kitten food. And I'm talking about the little cans of the wet kitten food, and they need a lot of it because they've had a lot of kittens come in, and the kittens can just not handle those big pieces of cat food. They just won't eat. So we just want to make sure that they get fed well and they get fed properly and they get the nutrition that they need to be happy and healthy pets. So if there's any way you can drop off some cans or even just the small dry kitten food would work well too, but we're really looking for the wet kitten food. That would be awesome, and you can donate it here at Kiwanis County Animal Control. But I just want to let you know real quickly some of the fundraisers that are going on with our group. We are going to be at La Poma's Pizza. That's right next to Thomas Crossing Elementary School on Wednesday, July the 19th from 5 to 8. That'll be one of our fundraisers for the cat program within the Noonan Coweta Humane Society. Like I said, La Poma's Pizza right there in that little shopping center right next to Thomas Crossroads Elementary, 5 to 8. This coming Wednesday, July the 19th. So come by, say hi, have some pizza, and it raises money to help save our cats. Also, we're gonna be at Bubbles and Brushes in the Ashley Park Shopping Center this Saturday, July 22nd, from 9 to 7. Come paint your heart out and save some animals too. We would love to see you there at Bubbles and Brushes this Saturday, July the 22nd, in Ashley Park, from all day, really, from 9 to 7. So come by and say hi then too. So guys, if you want to find out what else we're doing, please check out our website at nchsrescue.org. Also go ahead and look at our Facebook page and like our Facebook page while you're at it so you can find out more information about adoptions. We're still doing adoptions in Noonan at PetSmart, in Peachtree City at Petco, and also at the new pet supermarket in Sharpsburg. I believe that's Sharpsburg, Noonan area, Thomas Crossroads. As well, generally on Sundays, but check out the times on our website and on our Facebook page to get more information on that. So I just want to make sure that I thank Coweta County Animal Control for allowing us to come down to your facility and showcase these wonderful adoptable pets that you have available here. Also, thank you to New Link for making our show possible and for sending us Laura, the best camerawoman in all the world, to film the show and do a fantastic job making sure that she gets it out to you. Also, thank you to our volunteers for your time, your love, and all that you do to make our county, hopefully someday, a no homeless pets county. So thanks again for watching. We hope that you have a fabulous week, and we'll catch you next time.